Today we are implementing magic command inside Jupyter Notebook. First open Jupyter Notebook. Go to the search bar. Type Jupyter Notebook. Then click on open. This will open Jupyter Notebook. Code of this file you will get in the description below. After opening Jupyter Notebook, on the home page, open cell magic command.ipynb file. Open cell magic command ipynb. First magic command is %ls magic. It will list all the magic command available inside Jupyter Notebook. Magic commands are of two type. First is line magic and second is cell magic. Line magic is applicable to a single line, whereas cell magic is applicable to multi-line, that is complete cell. Click on the cell and press shift enter. It will list all the magic command available. Today we are implementing cell magic commands. First cell magic command is scalable vector graphics. Syntax is %SVG. As you format text in HTML, to format user defined graphics we use scalable vector graphics in XML. We use SVG tag. In this case printable area is 100-100, therefore attribute is width is equal to 100 and height is equal to 100. Graphics we are drawing is a circle, therefore we have given attribute as center of the circle CX is equal to 50, CY is equal to 50, radius of the circle R is equal to 40, border of the circle will be blue color, width of the border width will be 4 and the circle will be filled by brown color. Click on the cell, press shift enter, circle is drawn. Next cell magic command is write file. What it does, it writes the content of the current cell into an external file. Syntax is %% write file and the file name where you want to write the content of the current cell. In this case we have written a program for finding a prime number inside Python. First we have taken the number, we have implemented if else logic. The number is 1 or less than 1. Straightforwardly, if block will not be implemented, we will jump to else block and we will print that the number is not a prime number. If number is greater than 1, what we have done, we have checked from 2 to num minus 1 whether it is divisible by I. If it is divisible, then number is not a prime number and we come out of the loop. Otherwise, if this loop is completely implemented, means the number is prime number, we go to the else block and print the number is prime number. Click on the cell, press shift enter. In this case, what is done, the content of the cell is written to a file. In next cell we are running this file. Syntax is not python space file name. Click on the cell and then press shift enter. Input was 10 and 10 is not a prime number. Now we change our input, converting the input to 17, which is a prime number. Click on the cell, run the cell again by pressing shift enter. Cell has executed, then we run the same file. Another syntax for writing the content of the cell into an external file is %% file, which is equivalent to write file. %% file and the file name. Here we have printed one comment. Click on the cell, press shift enter. Content of the cell is written into the file. Then we run the file. Syntax is not python and then file name followed by file name. Click on the cell, then press shift enter. Next cell magic command is %HTML. It allows us to write HTML code inside Jupyter Notebook. Here we are rendering an external component as a HTML inside Jupyter Notebook. We are including a PDF using iframe tag. Syntax is iframe, then attribute source, link of the external component. Here I have given link of a PDF file, which is a shortcut for magic commands. Then I have said that the width should be 100%, means this PDF should cover the complete cell, and then ended iframe tag. Here you can implement all the tags of HTML. For demo purpose, I have implemented iframe for showing you that you can embed video or PDF also. Click on the cell, press shift enter, PDF will be displayed. You can see what is the use of including PDF. If you want to make your notebook descriptive, then you can use this feature. It is useful. You can run another language code inside Jupyter Notebook. In this case, we are running the code for JavaScript. Syntax is %JavaScript or %JS. First, %JavaScript. Here we are displaying a pop-up box. A syntax for displaying pop-up box with a message is alert. Alert, and in opening and closing parentheses, inside double quotes, the message. Click on the cell and then press shift enter. You can see pop-up block is displayed and hello, I am alert box. Next JavaScript code we have implemented is we have searched an element in a array. What we have done, we have taken first the size of the array, prompt enter the size of the array, then it will be converted into integer, then it is stored in n. Then we have dynamically created a array of size n. What is the syntax? Variable name is equal to new for dynamic memory allocation, then array, and then size. We have used a flag variable t. Initially t is 0, means the element is not found. We ran a loop from 0 to array length minus 1, and we have taken the content of the array from the user. Then we have taken the number to be found in k. Then the main logic of our code, we ran a loop from 0 to length minus 1, here less than sign. We checked whether k value is equivalent to the array content. If at any iteration of I this condition satisfy, we toggle our flag from 0 to 1 and come out of the loop using break statement. If this for loop runs completely, means t will not be toggled, t will remain 0 as it is. If t is 1, then we display a alert box that the element is found at the particular position where we capture the position in I. Otherwise, we display a alert box that element not found. Click on the cell, press shift enter. First it will ask you the size of the array. This case size of array is 5. Okay, element, first element is 10, second is 20, third is 30, fourth is 40, fifth is 50. Enter the element to be found. Suppose I enter 30, it prints element found at position 2. Second iteration where we give that element is not in the array. Click on the box, press shift enter. Enter the size of the array 5, first element 10, second 20, third 30, fourth 40, fifth 50. Now we enter 11, it displays element not found. Can run Ruby code also. Syntax will be %% Ruby. Next cell magic command is to render the latex output. In this case, we have displayed mathematical equation using latex. So syntax is %latex, the magic cell command. Then we have written a text. Then latex syntax for displaying mathematical equation. Slash begin in opening brace, keyword equation, closing brace. Then the actual equation, in this case equation y is equal to mx plus c. This equation is used in machine learning for linear regression, followed by syntax forward slash end, opening brace, keyword equation, and then closing brace. Click on the cell, press shift enter. You can see text is displayed and then mathematical equation is displayed, y is equal to mx plus c. This is important cell command for analyzing your code. Prun python profiler, it will give the analysis of execution of your code. Here we have taken a number program for a prime number which we have implemented above. What we will see, the time analysis of this program after running this cell. Click on the cell, press shift enter. You can see number of calls which have been done, total time for execution of this program, cumulative time for execution of this program for various modules. So one will be internal module and other one will be our main module, our code, and rest of them will be internal modules. Can close it. Can see. Means if you want to see how much time is taken by the code, by each subcomponent of the code, you will run Python profiler by %prun and you can analyze the complete code. Important cell magic command. You can run system commands. Syntax is %% system. In this case we are running dir. It will list the content of the current directory. You can system command, you can run display the date, can display time also. To calculate the time of the execution of your expression or your code, you can use %timeit or %time. What is the difference between %timeit and %time? %timeit will give you the time required after n number of iteration, means it will give average time execution of your expression or code. For example, in this case, if you run the current cell, it will show what time required for execution of this cell after multiple iteration, means it itself analyze the running time. You can see 9.5 will be the time required for running this code. It can vary plus minus 124 nanosecond. Means the standard deviation, means on average you will get 9.5 microsecond for running this cell. Whereas timeit will give what is the current time required for execution of this cell. Click on the cell, click on shift enter, and it will take some time because I have used sleep. Okay. Last cell command, you are running command prompt cell %cmd. In cmd I have opened a Jupyter notebook. Command is Jupyter notebook. Click on the cell, then press shift enter. This will open Jupyter notebook. If you want to run the command on the command prompt using Jupyter notebook, syntax is %cmd. For now For more technical contents, do hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Thank you.